Well, welcome everyone, this is Kerjim's channel. Now we are back to our new episodes of True Cinematic Champions and Comparison, featured by Wild Meat, Black of Legends versus the Mobile Legend Bang Bang. But before that, please like and subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click the bell button so you'll be notified to our new next episode video. Let's do this!
Kevin is a very dominant lane bully. One of Gnar's biggest strengths in lane is his range, and Kennen takes that away from him. But is this power able to translate over in solo queue? As we know, in solo queue, you're not just going to see 4 or 5 champions. The two biggest counters to Gnar today are Jace and Irelia, both very popular solo queue picks. But how good is Kennen in solo queue? Kennen is fantastic in solo queue. One of the biggest reasons that Kennen is just so damn strong is because of the item Hextech Protobelt. Hextech Protobelt is just perfect for Kennen. Like some of those other champions, getting a little too close can result in your own death. But with Kennen, the closer you are, the better. Hextech Protobelt is a ridiculously cost-efficient item. If we're judging this item simply based off its stats, it is 95% gold efficient. If you incorporate its active ability, this item should easily cost 2,800 gold. Champions who get really cheap first items, like Hextech Protobelt, can get a power spike before their lane opponents, and have a window of opportunity to kill them before their enemy does. In professional play, Kennen is really good because usually you'll have a lot of teamwork, a lot of coordination, to follow up on these really great plays. But as we know, in solo queue, it's a lot harder for people to follow up and to coordinate properly with your team. But here's the great thing about Kennen. Even if you go in 1v4, a lot of times you'll still trade at least 1-for-1 if you're strong. A lot of times, Kennen's ult basically scares his enemies away from peeling. But here's the real reason why Kennen can be so effective in solo queue. As I said before, in professional play, coordination is a lot easier. In solo queue, the way you counter Kennen, you need to rely on people with displacements and exhausts. The champions that have the most displacements in the game are generally junglers and supports. If you're playing top against a Kennen, a lot of times in teamfights, it's not up to you to stop Kennen, it's up to someone else on your team. If that support or jungler doesn't remember to use their ult for Kennen ult, or if they just use it for something else, Kennen can just destroy your entire team. You need displacements on your team, such as Gragas, Lee Sin, Alistar, Janna. If these players don't remember to use their crucial displacements for Kennen, it's a lot harder to stop him in a teamfight. Some players are so tunneled in into one specific area, they don't even see Kennen coming in.
When a new player isn't instantly obliterated by a steep learning curve, but rather a more gradual one that allows you to still win by getting carried from time to time, it makes for a far more enjoyable experience for new players and casuals. My question is, who is the most balanced champion in the game? Can we even pinpoint a single champion? And for that matter, based on what we just talked about, what even is the definition of balance? With the meta having so much emphasis on high skill cap 1v1 styled mid lane carries, we saw plenty of those types of champions picked and banned during the tournament. You had a good amount of Zed bans, Rengar bans, Yasuo, and Fizz bans, and despite not being banned too much, Kha'Zix was the most picked champion at Worlds that year. But who were the two most prevalent champions then at the tournament? Was it Lee Sin? Was it Talon maybe? Well, the champion that never made it through untouched in some way at a whopping 100% picker ban was Alistar. This was not because of support Alistar, though he could still be played at support if you wanted to. In reality, this was because of top lane Alistar and the abuse of a Trinity Force interaction or bug. This is a topic that deserves a video all on its own, but the TLDR is that you could auto-attack somebody after you headbutt them, essentially giving a zero counterplay combo with a Sheen proc, where you would just headbutt and auto-attack as they're being knocked back. and it made it pretty much impossible to lane against him, hence the pretty much 100% ban rate aside from a few picks where he got through. Number 2 on this list wasn't far behind him though, at a 96.2 pick or ban for the entire tournament, and that was Zilli. He definitely was not the 1v1 OP assassin that you can use to make your first league montage, and Zilean was a supportive mid that had no shields or hard crowd control, such that a Lulu could work her way into mid lane. As the year progressed, the player base began to realize just how strong he could be. Along with other old relics of the game that never really see changes like Anivia and Kennen, might be the closest thing to League's perfectly balanced champions.
Because a lot of people expect a lot of damage from him early game or stuff like that, but he's more of a, you know, mid-late game champion. Like, you gotta give this champion more appreciation. You gotta kind of play these champions. Like, but there's also many different ways to play this champion, which is why I'm making this chat. So anyways, let's just stop babbling and let's get straight into Kennen's ability. So firstly, we'll start off with Kennen's passive, which is Mark of the Storm. Enemies hit by Kennen's abilities receive a Mark of the Storm for 6 seconds, stacking up to 3 times, and at 3 stacks, the marks consume themselves to stun the target for 1.25 seconds, and restores 25 energy. If the stun is applied more than once within 6 seconds, its duration is reduced to 0.5 seconds, and that'll make more sense once we go into further abilities. So next we'll go Thundering Shuriken. Kennen throws a charged shuriken in a line in front of him, dealing magic damage to the first enemy hit. Now the one thing to be aware about Kennen's abilities is, though this ability is simple, all of his abilities are going to add to his passive. Anything you damage with the enemies with on Kennen's abilities is going to apply a stack to them. Then we'll look at Kennen's W, which is Electrical Surge. Kennen deals bonus magic damage and applies a Mark of the Storm once every 5 basic attacks. Now this is the passive for the ability. And then the active for the ability is Kennen sends out a surge of electricity to all nearby enemies afflicted by Mark of the Storm or caught in slicing maelstrom, dealing magic damage. So this is basically a point and click ability that's used for anyone that already has marks on them. Then we'll move on to Kennen's E, which is Lightning Rush, which is pretty much Kennen's signature ability. Kennen transforms into a ball of electricity, disarming himself but becoming ghosted and gaining 100% bonus movement speed for 2 seconds, while also gaining bonus armor and magic resistance while active. Kennen deals magic damage to all enemies he passes through, which is halved against non-champions, and restores 40% energy the first time the Lightning Rush damages an enemy. Kennen gains bonus attack speed for 4 seconds upon exiting Lightning Rush, and Kennen can reactivate Lightning Rush to prematurely cancel it, allowing him to use the basic attacks again. This is why it's good for the attack speed burst that you get for when you're exiting the E ability. Then we'll look at Kennen's ultimate, which is Slicing Maelstrom. Kennen summons a magical storm around himself for 3 seconds, dealing magic damage to all enemies within the range, every 0.5 seconds. Each Maelstrom hit applies a Mark of the Storm, up to maximum of 3, which is going to apply the stun at the end of it. Slicing Maelstrom deals 10% increased damage with each successive strike against a target, up to the maximum of 150% damage with 1 strike. And this is going to be the ability that you're going to be using in team fights, and you'll understand why Kennen is such a good team fighting champion. Now, the one thing that to keep in mind about all of Kennen's abilities is, of course, they're going to be applying the stacks and they make up for his passive. His Q ability is going to be used because it's very far ranged and it's probably going to be the last resort that you use when you're doing your trades. Your W ability is so easy to proc, all you have to do is walk up in range to your enemies and press W as long as they have the mark applied from previously. And then your E ability is used for engaging, disengaging, and kiting. This ability shouldn't always be used. Like, it shouldn't always be used to, like, engage onto your enemy unless you know you can do a really nice all-in winning the trade and making sure that it was safe to do so. But I think saving it is really good only because it's really good for avoiding jungle ganks along with kiting as well, because the amount of attack speed burst that you get from the E ability is freaking amazing. And you don't always have to use your E and W to clear waves. Your E ability can be used to run into all of the minions and put a stack on them, and then your W can actually clear all of the minions, or it can do a heck ton of damage more to them, but this shouldn't always be used. You want to try using your enemy to push up to you so you can deny them minions, and so you can freeze your wave and get opportunities for your jungler as well. And then your ultimate ability is going to be the biggest ability that you use for team fights. You're always going to use this for team fights, or for when you need to all-in your enemy laner and it's going to assure you a kill. Your ultimate ability is probably the best thing that you're going to revolve around throughout this entire game, which is why it's really important to keep it whenever you need it, and it's mostly used to help your teammates rather than yourself. Now let's look at Kennen's runes. Now I've got 4 different rune pages to show you that's going to not only show you my preference but a lot of other people's preferences, because I've done a bunch of research and I saw like other Kennen builds or runes that you can apply to him, and it's actually pretty fun to do, and it's actually providing a different playstyle for Kennen whenever you're playing him. But firstly, the most common Kennen rune page is going to be this one, which has Kleptomancy, Magical Footwear, Minion Dematerializer, and Cosmic Insight, Taste of Blood, and Ultimate Hunter, having two Adaptive Force runes, and having one Health rune. Now, Kleptomancy is so easy to proc on Kennen, only because of his E ability. After he exits E, he can always auto-attack twice on the enemy, only because he gets a huge attack speed burst, and it helps him proc both of the Kleptomancy. And then you can go Magical Footwear so you can get the boots later, along with getting them sooner as long as you get kills. Minion Dematerializer will help with farming with Kennen, because it is not easy to farm with Kennen. It's actually very difficult, and I think it takes a bit of practice to farm with Kennen, just like by raw auto-attacking. And then Cosmic Insight is mainly to have overall CDR, mainly the summoner spells, because these are going to be very useful for when it comes to teleporting to your bot lane or into teamfights, or for split pushing if necessary. And then for secondary, you go Taste of Blood and Ultimate Hunter. Kennen doesn't have a lot of sustain, so Taste of Blood makes sense to go there. And Ultimate Hunter allows Kennen's ultimate to be up quicker. And because Kennen's mostly going to be in teamfights, his Ultimate Hunter stacks are going to be full very fast. And the reason I go two Adaptive Force runes is because that early damage is really good, and I don't think you should go the attack speed. My personal favorite, and the one I always use, is going to be this page, which has Kleptomancy, Perfect Timing, Futures Market, and Cosmic Insight, with Taste of Blood and Ravenous Hunter. Now, we already explained what Kleptomancy is good for. Perfect Timing is actually more expensive than Magical Footwear, which is why I went this rune, so I can get it quicker, and it really helps for divers. So it's very gold efficient, and I think boots are very easy to get, along with having Futures Market, because you get your Hextech Revolver very fast, because that's going to be the item that you're gonna build. And then having to go the combo of Taste of Blood and Ravenous Hunter provides for a lot of sustain. I think this is going to be one of the best Kennen pages, and I think you guys should definitely try this one. Now here's another Kennen page that shows a lot for movement speed. You can go Phase Rush, Nimbus Cloak, Celerity, and Gathering Storm, ending off with Taste of Blood and Ultimate Hunter. Now Phase Rush is gonna give you the movement speed buff when you're attacking enemies three times. Your Nimbus Cloak is the reason that you're going to be moving faster when you ulti, and Celerity is gonna give you 10% more movement speed. So if you activate your ultimate, and if you run into the enemy team with Phase Rush, Nimbus Cloak, and Celerity all at once, you will move so fast, and you will capture everybody in your ultimate, leaving them stunned, and it helps you catch up to everyone and make sure you finish off the kill. And Gathering Storm is to help you scale with late game. And then if you want to go for more of a poke option, you can always go Summon Airy and Scorch. Summon Airy is going to be, like, up all the time, so you can use that to poke your enemy, and Scorch is going to be burning them for extra damage. And then we stick with the Nimbus Cloak and Celerity. But in this case, I think more on the Phase Rush. So now that we're done with Kennen's runes, we're going to be looking over at his builds. Now, when it comes to starter items, you always want to go Doran's Blade and go a Healing Pot. Now, the reason you do that is because you get a lot of auto-attack damage on the enemy, along with getting Lifesteal from the Doran's Blade itself. And going Darksteel or Doran's Ring doesn't really matter, only because Kennen does have energy, and it's going to be like a waste of the stats. But to be fair, I think Doran's Blade is still the better option, regardless of even having to go the other two items. And then when it comes to your core starter, you want to go Hextech Revolver as soon as you can, because you want to build into a Hextech Protobelt as soon as you can. And then when it comes to boots, you want to get Sorcerer's Shoes. You'll soon have your stopwatch either from your rune or from when you're buying, so you can get yourself a Zhonya's along with the Fiendish Codex. And you want to get your Kindle Gem, of course, to build into your Protobelt. Your Protobelt is going to be your first and main core item, only because it gives you that nice little push for when you need to keep people in your ultimate or when you want to capture people. And when it comes to the boots, you want to go the boots that's going to prioritize around the game. And then Zhonya's Hourglass is going to be your second core item, only because it can be activated while your ultimate is active as well, so it can still damage them while you're protected by the Zhonya's Hourglass, so nobody can target you. Marillion Omicron is a super good item, especially against matchups like Nasus, to prevent any of the lifesteal, especially like Vladimir or anyone like that, because this item afflicts previous wounds, and it has some magic penetration as well. You want to go for as much damage as you can. Rabadon's Deathcap should be an item that you build either 4th or 5th. It's a really good item, of course, because it does a heck ton of damage, and with Kennen, you want to have as much damage as you can early on in the game. Banshee's Veil is good for a top lane matchup for when you need more magic resist, and the item has a heck ton of AP as well, so why not? Void Staff is probably one of Kennen's best items too, only because of the amount of penetration it's provided, along with going with Sorcerer's Shoes, so you have a lot of magic penetration and AP to make up for how much damage you do and to shred tanks. I think Rylai's Crystal Clear Scepter is a decent item only because the amount of slow it provides to the enemies, especially when you're using your ultimate. So not only does it stun them, but it also slows them while you're using the first parts of your ultimate before it actually stuns. Liandry's Torment is probably going to be Kennen's third core item only because it works so well with your ultimate and it provides a lot of burn. Spellbinder is probably a really good item too only because of the movement speed active that you get along with giving you a heck ton of AP when you're engaging, especially at full stats. Gnasher's Tooth can be somewhat of an option. I don't think it's maybe the best item, but I think it's an item that still could work on Kennen along with Luden's Echo. These two items are not the best items on Kennen, but I think they can still be put to use in a certain way. The reason I say that is because I've put these items to use and it's been useful in different ways. But they're very situational items. I wouldn't say these are like the best top tip items, but they could be used in a way you can make them viable. So if you need to expand out for builds, go ahead for it. But for now, stick with the items that I've given you, because these are going to be the items that are going to be really useful for when you're playing Kennen. And then whenever you're at full build, you always get the Elixir of Sorcery. Occasionally buy Control Wards. Don't always use so much gold on Control Wards as well, because you're going to be needing a lot of gold for your items. Unless you got Futures Market, then it's a fair enough deal to go for Control Wards. And then you can go Oracle in case they have a Teemo or you want to deny vision, and then you can go Blue Wards for later game if nobody else on your team has, so you can provide more vision.